Celestial events of 2018.
Happy New Year and welcome to Stargazers. I'm Dean Regas, astronomer from the Cincinnati Observatory.
And I'm James Albury, director of the Kika Silva Pla Planetarium in Gainesville, Florida. With last year's total solar eclipse, 2017 was an amazing year for stargazing, but 2018 has some really cool events too.
That's right, James. Stargazers have plenty to look forward to in 2018. We have meteor showers, conjunctions, two total lunar eclipses, and a supermoon.
So, let's get started outlining the celestial events to look for in 2018. All right, let's start off with moon stuff. January 2018 is a great month for the moon. First off, we'll have not one, but two full moons. The first is on January 1st, and the second happens 30 days later on January 31st. When you have two full moons in the same calendar month, it's known as a blue moon.
Blue moons are not really blue, but the January 31st blue moon will actually turn red. Yes, this blue moon is also going to be a blood moon. In other words, there will also be a total lunar eclipse on the morning of January 31st. The moon will pass through the darker part of the Earth's shadow, and the refracted sunlight passing through the Earth's atmosphere will make the moon appear red for over an hour.
Unfortunately, for those of us on the east coast of the United States, we will only get to see the beginning of this lunar eclipse. The good thing is, the further west you live, the more of the eclipse you'll get to see. Oh, and wait, there's more. The moon is also near perigee during this eclipse, so we'll have a
super moon.
Can you believe it? We'll have a super blue blood moon.
That's pure lunacy. Moving on to meteor showers. We have four meteor showers this year that promise to be worth your while because the moon won't interfere with them.
That's right, Dean. The moon will be in the waxing phases for all four meteor showers. In the spring, we have the Lyrids, which peaks on the morning of April 23rd.
Then in the summer, we have the Perseid meteor shower on the morning of August 13th.
In late autumn, we have the Leonids, which peak on the morning of November 18th.
And on December 14th, we have the Geminids, which should be an excellent display this year because the first quarter moon sets near midnight, leaving the morning hours nice and dark so we can see the fainter meteors.
Now on to the planets. Mars, Jupiter, and Saturn will all achieve opposition near the middle of 2018. Jupiter will be at its closest to us on May 9th, Saturn on June 27th, and Mars on July 27th.
And speaking of July 27th, the full moon will be in conjunction with the planet Mars on that day.
Did you say conjunction?
Oh no, not again.
Cue the music.
Yes, the moon appears very close to Mars that night. And if you happen to be traveling to Western Africa, Western Europe, or Eastern Asia, you get to experience the second total lunar eclipse of 2018.
That's right, Dean. We have a conjunction, a planetary opposition, and an eclipse all in the same night. I can barely contain my excitement.
Well, you can if you try.
Speaking of conjunctions, let's conclude this episode by listing some of the more notable planet-to-planet scoochies to look for in 2018. At the end of this week, on January 7th, Mars and Jupiter will be in conjunction, and less than half a full moon width apart in the early morning sky.
Mercury and Venus will be in conjunction in the evening sky on March 5th.
Mars and Saturn will be in conjunction in the morning sky on April 2nd.
Mercury and Venus will be in conjunction again later this year on October 14th.
And Jupiter and Mercury will have two conjunctions as well this year. The first is the day before Halloween on October 30th, and the second is on the winter solstice on December 21st.
And speaking of conjunctions on December 21st, mark your calendar for December 21st, 2020. Because shortly after sunset, Jupiter and Saturn will have a super close conjunction, and they'll be less than a tenth of a degree apart at their closest.
Man, that's gonna be amazing. I'll be dancing all month.
So, happy 2018 and happy stargazing. It's all there waiting for you as you
keep looking up.